All right, let's go to the finals. Yes, I would like to play first, and yes, this hand is quite good. We have a turn one play, we have a great early creature, we have a great removal spell, and you know, plenty of lands to do all that, so. Our opponent did go down to 5, which is good news, I guess. All right, let's go ahead and drop a vessel. Opponent played a tap land, turn one. We are going to play something quite better on our turn two, in the form of the Squad Recruiter. Maybe he'll even, you know, pass the turn without doing anything, meaning that we won't get to you know, search for creatures during our turn. But if that's the case, you get to play the Apothecary Geist. Alright. You see, I like your deck already. I do like my deck too. So, let's take a look at the top 3 cards here, see if we find anything. Yeah, we did find something. What happens to the rest on the bottom of the library? Sure. So our guy will flip, and possibly next turn we'll get to play both our creatures, which would be awesome. Because, you know, because of this ability here. Alright. Another one of those. Doesn't have a land. Interesting. Let's attack then. Then we get to do this. And this. Then our guy comes back. We'll get to, you know, keep digging for creatures here. You know, eventually we're just gonna go ahead and exile all of these guys. Yeah, this is probably gonna happen soon enough here. Alright, so if he attacks with both, we are taken. Right, he's looking at the top 2 cards of his library. Drawing one of them. Discarded, I mean, not discarded, but he put the island on the graveyard. Right, I won't block. So, what am I gonna do here? I think I play a forest. I think I attack with my team and I play a declaration in stone. I mean, do I really need to? I'm not sure, to be perfectly honest with you. Not sure. I don't think we need to. Is that 11? Like, he may play something that's more important for us to kill here, right? Let's take a look here, get a Moorland Drifter. And play the Moorland Drifter. Not blocking if he attacks, obviously. So if he doesn't play anything, I guess during my upkeep I do look at the top 3 cards of my library in search of a creature. This card's so insane, by the way. I mean, it's a constructed card, right? Let's play. Played in standard. Oh, he's gonna play something. Fevered Visions. That's interesting. Alright, so I guess next turn I do play a Declaration of Stone, because what's gonna happen is I'm gonna have to race him. Oh, right. That's fine by me too. I'm gonna draw cards. Ooh, Overworld Mysteries. That's excellent. So, let's go ahead and play it. Then we get to do this. How cool is that? Then we hit him for a bunch. Probably enough to take the game, right? And then we draw a card. This is why like Declaration in Stone is so good in aggressive decks. So much better in aggressive decks. My opponent, he does not have the time to just crack these clues. So that was a free spell. Insane. 2 mana, exile 2 of his guys. Alright. That was a nice game 1. Hopefully the game 2 is just like that. Nothing that I want to bring in again. Scavenger. Well, could perhaps bring in a scavenger since we are on the draw. If he comes out the gate swinging, but we have no reason to believe that his deck does that, right? No actual reason. I mean, if he's playing the Fervid Visions, he's probably aggro. And either way, if I am to bring that thing in, what do I take out here? One Unrelimog, perhaps. I think that may be a nice switch, because the Unrelimog on the draw against him, he's a blue deck, so he probably is going to be able to bounce my Unrelimog once he gets really big. So yeah, I think I would rather have a wall there, a cheap wall that can attack later in the game. Right, I'm not mulling this. This is a bit land heavy, but I do have an early creature and I do have a great removal spell. Alright. That's excellent too. Is he going to. Oh, alright. Insolent Neonate. Love that card, by the way. The good news here is that this guy may be active really soon here, depending on what we reveal with our Vessel of Nascency here. Because next turn, that's probably what we are going to do. Just play the Vessel and sack it. We're going to do it during my turn too, so that if we manage to hit the perfect combination of cards, our guy can start growing on his turn already. Alright, for Visions. That's going to be quite good with my Sage, isn't it? It is. Oh, he did not attack. That's interesting. I guess he doesn't remember that his guy has menace. So let's attack him. He's probably not blocking, unless I'm missing something here. So, let's play a Vessel, let's sack the Vessel. Alright, yeah, well, not quite there yet on Delirium, but we are going to get a Solitary Hunter here. My hand, the rest in my graveyard. I guess at least we did take out a bunch of lands that we were going to draw. Right, taking one. Sure. So let's attack. He doesn't have 5 mana, so he does not, you know, I don't fear that guy. The 3/3 flyer. Ooh, he probably has something. Alright. Jace's Scrutiny. Taking a bunch of damage here. But the good news is that I'm going to play a Sage of Ancient Lore next turn, and it's going to be just massive. Alright. That thing could end up killing us, if we're not careful, by the way. Especially if he has more than one. So next turn we're gonna attack with our Solitary Hunter. Probably not with the Skinner, because, you know, he's probably gonna have something here too. Either he's gonna play something during his turn, or he's going to leave men open to play his big flyer there, the 3-3 guy. Alright, I'm taking one damage here. So he's just trying to race me. I mean, he is drawing a lot of cards, right? Thanks to the Fervor Dream. I am too, but I am taking a lot of damage because of that. And I think he may have done that just to prevent my guy from flipping. Which is, you know, it's fine. Alright. Sanguinary Mage. I'm gonna draw another card. Right, so what are we going to do here? Just attack with this guy. And draw, then play a Sage. And when this Sage flips, when it transforms, they're gonna be a bit messy here, aren't they? Ooh, what's that? We're gonna have some sort of spell here. Right. So he basically did nothing here. He just prevented the damage that I would cause this turn. Let's play this guy. It's gonna be a 7-7. Ooh. You know what? I think I'm gonna discard this. Yep, I will. So that I can start doing this. Not sure if I'm gonna be able to just go ahead and try to flip my guy next turn. Angelic Purge targeting my 7-10. Sure. So I'm taking 3 damage here. Yeah, this is gonna be tough. I think next turn I'm gonna play a bunch of cards here, just because I would like to stop taking damage from that thing. Is he going to kill my Obsessive Skinner too? I guess we shall find out soon enough here. Right, taking 3 damage. Ooh, Synthrada. Now that's interesting. Very interesting indeed. 1-2, 1-2, 3-1. So what do we do here? It's gonna be tough. Don't think I can afford to attack here at this point. I'll just play, let's see, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Could just go ahead and play the Emissary, but in that case Yeah, we do take damage here, but I think next turn we'll be able to dump four cards from our hand, right? So yeah, let's play the emissary. This is, you know, it's gonna be kind of it's gonna be risky because, you know, I could just go ahead and dump a bunch of guys onto the battlefield here. But the problem here, obviously, is that in that situation, I will not make the best use of my mana. So let's go ahead and play this guy. During his upkeep, I guess I'll bounce the Obsessive Skinner himself. Right, I'm down to 5. That's scary. That's a scary card. Gotta be honest here. So, reveal a land, please. That's 2 mana spends. Oh, Jesus. Favorite Visions. Alright, well, I cannot pay for that, can I? If I do pay for that, let's see, during my turn, I would draw a card, play a land. I would dump 3 cards. 4 cards, right? Yeah, I'm dead. Man. That's a nice one. So he does have multiple Forever Divisions, which is pretty impressive, I have to tell him. I don't think I have a way around that, do I? So if he attacks with his team, he does lose a Sting Prodder though, so. I mean, he loses 2 guys, right? Right. Okay, well. Now this is interesting. Let's see, let's play a land. We get to, let's see, play 1, 2, 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, yeah. Oh, yeah. The third one has to be this thing, by the way, because otherwise, I mean, we don't have enough. Oh no, we do. We do have enough white mana for that, don't we? Let's play this thing. Let's play this thing. And then we could play this thing, targeting his Sin Prodder, targeting his 4-card Borgia. Nah, I think I'll just play the Byway Courier. And we cannot attack, sadly. Because, let's see, if we attack, he bashes with everything. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 creatures, and we will need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So basically, if he draws into a removal spell here, we are dead. You make me draw 2 cards here, so next turn I'm actually going to attack him with everything that I have. I'm gonna put a counter here, I suppose. On the 5, sure. Now here is Machinations. Oh, well. I obviously cannot pay to life here. So if he doesn't have a removal spell, I get one last shot next turn. He doesn't know that I have the burn from within, so. And I do hope he attacks here, but he's probably not going to. Isn't that right? Let's see, I deal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 damage to him next turn. The Nahiri's Machinations is not going to save him from that. I don't think he has any nice attacks here. 1, 2. Yeah, he only does 2 damage to whatever I block with. Oh, bummer, he has another creature. Still, he doesn't know what I have in hand, right? So, maybe I can, you know, trick him into taking 9 damage here. So, which of his guys is gonna get, is gonna be indestructible? That guy. Right. So, is he going to attack? I don't suppose he will. I mean, I really do want him to attack, but I don't suppose he will. No, he is. Right. So I attack him with this thing. I mean, I block him with this thing. And I block him with this guy, maybe? Nah, you know what? Yeah, like, blocking with this guy will make this a 2-2, right? Guess I block with this guy. 1, 2, 3, 4. He does not get to kill my guy. Oops, what's that? Magic Online was acting out here. So yeah, during my turn, I'm gonna attack with the bunch here, with the whole team. Right. Oh no. Oh, he's gonna kill my guy. Oh man, that's kind of bad. So either way, we are attacking with the team here, aren't we? We are. Let's think for a second. What can we do here? Can we play like... If I have 4 or more, right? Can I keep only one card in my hand? I don't think I can. Like 2, 3 plus 3. 2, 3, 3, 3 cards, yeah. Does not work. So I'll just attack with everything here. Hopefully, he doesn't do anything. I can only do 7 damage to him, meaning that I have to do 11 damage. Meaning that he cannot block any of my creatures. Yeah, like I thought, that is not going to happen. So he's taking what? 8 damage down to 10 damage, down to 10 life here. And I cannot deal with 10 life, sadly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Of course, I'm not gonna show him the card that I have. 2, 1, 2, 3. So, yeah. I'll just lose this one here. So yeah, that's interesting. Is there anything that I want here against him? Stuff that gain you life, maybe? C- could take out something like, you know, really mob. Fork in a road. Not sure if I take out a fork in the road. I don't think I do, actually. I mean, I could just take it out and, you know, try to get the mountain the hard way here. This way I'd have more creatures that gain life. Yeah, I feel like I have to out-aggro him, so I have no time to for cute shenanigans. I would like to play first, and yes, this is a perfectly keepable hand. Again, we could be leaving the dream as soon as turn 3 here. And by leaving the dream, I mean having this thing active. Alright. I guess I could do that, couldn't I? Could, but I don't think I will. I'll just, you know, go ahead and trade. What I need here is to not take a lot of damage in order to survive and to be able to play my mid-range creatures that may be able to finish the job. It's too bad that I'll have to, you know, just lose that thing. Maybe I won't. Not sure. If he attacks, I could just not block. And if he doesn't attack, I guess I could burn his guy from within. Nah, you know what? I'll take it. I will. So, I'll attack him with this guy. I'll play my 3-2, and this one is gonna block. If you can, of course. Right, so he may have the fever dreams. Ooh. Alright, well, that's fine by me, because, like, he's not gonna race me by, you know, just having this on the battlefield. My board position is better. I could just aim this at this thing, but I'm thinking I'll just aim it at his face eventually. Oh, nice. Next turn I get to... Alright, it's fine. Next turn I get to play this guy. Ooh, bound by Meteor. Nice one. Right. So, play my werewolf. Attack him with my team. And next turn, we will try to finish things off. I mean, can we even? He's going down to 13 now. I have 8 power total on the battlefield. Meaning that I have to deal 5 damage. Yeah, I cannot win the game next turn. So, if I draw land, I get to play the Bound by Moonlight, by Moon Silver, on one of his creatures and just attack. Right. Could do that. Let's see. I'm gonna search for something here. Ooh. Open all the mysteries, huh? That's a recruiter too, but I think I like the mysteries better. So, play the mysteries and just bash his face in with everything. he may have some. Alright, he doesn't. I was gonna say he may have some sort of vampire card just to discard here and play it to block. But if he does, it's gonna have to be a 2-mana one. Alright, well, I'm gonna have a lot of of clues here to make humans with and draw cards with. So I guess next turn I get to just let my guy flip. Alright, I don't even need to. It's great. Attacking with this guy. I guess I will crack a clue right now. Oh, does he have that thing that destroys the attacker? I think the flood is real. Yep. So I'm gonna sack this thing. See if I draw into a land. And if I do, I'm gonna play the apothecary. Or maybe I don't. Because he may have. Yeah, I don't. He may have some sort of mass removal here. In that case, you know, I think I probably still win this game, but. So, did he draw into something? I feel like we're pretty close to winning here. Especially because we're probably going to win anyway, thanks to our burn from within. Got favorite visions too late. GG, nice deck. Because his deck really is nice. I mean, favorite vision is aggro. Screw in the first, flute in the third, but that's how it goes. Indeed. Thank you. Alright, so. It'd be good to play more for friendlies. Yeah. You would. Alright, so I guess. Cheers. Gonna make me work for you. Alright, he just considered. So there we go. One more season point here for us, and you know, a few reps. Thanks for watching and see you next time.